Hello everyone, this is Annabelle, the founding and managing partner from the London and Paris-based law firm Crefovie. Today I want to talk to you about an issue which has cropped up a lot since the occurrence of COVID-19 and Brexit, which is that a lot of our clients are experiencing difficulty to get their invoices paid by their debtors. And therefore they come to us and say, well, would you please help us, Crefovie, in order to collect those bad debts. And I wanted to give you a piece of advice about that. Well, bad debts are less likely to incur if you have some very clear terms and conditions of sale and provision of services or sale of goods, and AVR in particular compliant with the UK and the French distance selling regulations. At the moment, of course, everything is being done through distance selling. Therefore, your terms and conditions of sale should be set out on your website as part of your, you know, bundle of terms and conditions for your website. So that includes the terms and conditions of use of your website, terms and conditions of sale of your services and goods, and the cookies and privacy policies. And so those terms and conditions for the provision of your services and sale of goods and products should also be set out in any emails, any communication that you send to your clients, as well as the invoice. Obviously, the invoice should be compliant with UK or French regulations relating to invoices, so it should have your VAT number, it should contain the address of your business, it should contain the company's house reference of your business, or the number of registration under the Registre du Commerce et des Sociétés in France. So everything needs to be, you know, really perfect in terms of providing your terms and conditions of sales, and also providing some invoices which are compliant with UK and French law in relation to accounting and invoices. Also, if and when you want to provide an emergency service to a client, say for example you have a plumbing business, so clients call you and they have some pipes bursting and they are therefore under an emergency, and they call you or they email you or they contact you from a website. So this is definitely a distance selling sale. In this case, you need to make sure that your clients confirm that they waive their right to the 14 days cooling off period. Okay, as part of those distance selling regulations, which I mentioned before, a consumer client, so not a professional, but a consumer client, has 14 days to rescind the sale, to say, I don't want these products or I don't want these services. Therefore, if you have to provide these services or send the goods before the 14 days period, you need to make sure that your clients have waived this right to have this 14 days cooling off period. Okay, otherwise we can say, well, we're not going to pay the invoice because we have actually, you know, we've decided that we don't want the services anymore. But the problem is that you've already provided the service because it was an emergency before the 14 days period. So that's not great. And finally, so this is the work that you have to do, you know, preemptively to ensure that you don't have any bad debts, difficulties to collect your payments. And when you have, unfortunately, it can still occur that you have some clients who don't want to pay their invoices, then in this case, the best approach is to indeed contact a solicitor or an avocat, depending on where your business is located, and ask him or her to draft and to send a letter before court action, which will include, among other things, the reference to the pre-litigation protocol as per the civil procedural laws in the UK, and references also to the accrued interest as per the French civil code rules relating to sending some lettres de mise en demeure. So the lawyer will send this to your debtor, and will also set out in this letter before court action, this letter de mise en demeure, de payer, that if the payment has not been made within a certain date, usually around 15 days, it can be between 8 and 15 days, then your business will actually file a claim in front of the competent courts. So in the UK, and if you don't manage to sort out this issue by then following up with a client, with a debtor who has received such letter before court action and attempting to negotiate and to get collection, to get payment of your invoice, then you will indeed have to file a claim. So in the UK, if the amount is less than £10,000, it will be in front of a small claims court, which is at the county court of the place where the debtor is located. And for the French French territory, it will be in front of a tribunal d'instance, of a tribunal judiciaire, sorry, now the name is tribunal judiciaire, but in front of a pôle de proximité, if the amount at stake is less than €10,000. If it is above €10,000, then it will be filed in front of a tribunal, the tribunal judiciaire, but the section which used to be called the tribunal de grande instance, where you also have to actually have a lawyer, an avocat, to defend you in front of this, during this litigation. So don't hesitate to contact us if you have these difficulties of getting payment on your collection of your payments on outstanding invoices in the UK and France. We are here to support you to resolve these issues. Bye for now.